Good morning, students. Welcome to political science class. Today we will do the first chapter, Constitution, Why and How. Constitution. Constitution means set of basic rules. Rules or regulation ki ek book, jisko hum simply keh sakte hain kanoon ki kitab. Har country ki ek kanoon ki kitab hoti hai. Bina kanoon ke, bina rules and regulation ke, koi bhi country run nahi kar sakti. Chahe wo democratic country ho, chahe wo monarch country ho. अगर एक किंग रूल भी है तो किंग के भी रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस होते हैं दैट यू नो. सो नाउ वी विल रीड व्हाई डू वी नीड अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फर्स्ट नीड इज इट अलाउज कोऑर्डिनेशन एंड अश्योरेंस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द फोकस मस्ट बी ऑन द वर्ड कोऑर्डिनेशन. यू नो दैट इन अ ह्यूज कंट्री लाइक इंडिया देयर इज अ डाइवर्सिटी. पीपल बिलोंगिंग टू डिफरेंट लैंग्वेज ग्रुप, डिफरेंट रिलीजन, different culture are living together. How they are living together peacefully? Because there are some set of basic rules of the country, and these rules and regulation must be enforceable so that everyone must have the assurance that it will be followed by all. We can take the example of school, that in a school there are some basic rules and regulation, and students are coming from different backgrounds. And everyone's culture or timetable at home may be different, but when they are coming to school, their timetable will be same. So we need some basic rules and regulations so that we can coordinate the activities of all 2000 students, and it will be followed by every student, so that every student must have the assurance that it will be followed by all. And if one will not follow, then it will be punished by the institution. Second point is specification of decision-making power. Now, Constitution specifies who will have the decision-making power and who will be the law-making body. First of all, we must know that in a monarchy, the power lies in the hands of monarch. And we are living in a democracy. Democracy means people rule, public rule. So, people will have the decision-making power. But it is not simple. We are 130 crore. 130 crore people cannot take decision unanimously. So we rule through, when there is a big institution, we rule through representatives. And in our country too, we are ruling through representative. People vote for the representative and representative take decision on the behalf of people. So when people vote for the representative, there is a National Assembly, which is called Parliament in our country. So Parliament is the decision-making body in our country, and they decide that who will constitute the government. Now the next point is limitations on the powers of government. In the previous point, you have read that there is a specification of decision-making power in the Constitution, and they decide that who will constitute the government. But there are some limitations on the powers of government. Government ka matlab ye nahi hai ki unke paas sari ultimate power aa gayi. There are some limitation on the powers of the government. We can take the example of a democratic country like India, that in a democratic country, the supreme power is in the hands of people. Means fundamental rights of the people are supreme. No law can be made which is above these fundamental rights of the people. So there are, government cannot make any rule and regulation which is limiting or which is reducing the fundamental rights of the citizens. But there is one exception to this rule, that in case of national emergency, in case of curfews, or in case of army rule, these fundamental rights of the people are suspended, and at that time government can be more powerful than the people. Next point is aspirations and goals of a society. In a good constitution, aspirations and goals of societies are always mentioned in the constitution. Har society ki ek aspiration, ek umeed hoti hai ki jo unki country mein kuch negative practices chal rahi thi, uska end ho jaye. Jaise India mein kabhi caste discrimination tha, aur ab wo caste discrimination jo hai wo bilkul bhi nahi hai, kyunki jab hamara constitution banaya gaya तो उसके प्रीएम्बल में भी, उसके बहुत सारी लॉज की प्रोविजंस में ये चीज़ ऐड कर दी गई दैट देयर विल बी अ नो डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. वी कैन टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ इंडिया, दैट इन फंडामेंटल राइट्स The first fundamental right, right to equality, it is mentioned that no discrimination on the grounds of caste, creed, sex, gender, etc. And we can take the another example of South Africa too, that there was a racial discrimination, apartheid followed in the country, that blacks were discriminated against the white. But when they made the new constitution, they mentioned about the ending of that racial discrimination. So in good constitutions, it is always mentioned about the aspirations and the goals of the society. Now the final point is fundamental identity of a people. In every constitution, there is a collective identity of the people, like political, they got the political identity, that all have the voting rights, how the government will be chosen, what are their voting rights, etc. So they got the collective identity called political identity, that they have some political rights, and under political identity, they can pursue their individual goals or aspirations. The condition under which, or the platform under which, the individuals are fulfilling their aspirations and goals comes under the moral identity. So both are called as fundamental identity of a people, which is always respected in any constitution. So this was the need of constitution. This topic is over. Next topic we will do in the next video. Till then, stay home, study from home, and be safe. Thank you.